Hey guys, so before we hop into the video, I just want to take this opportunity to address a few things. Although there are disclaimers throughout the video, I just want to start off with the disclaimer that everything in this video is my opinion. That means that it's not fact, which means just because I say that it's things that Black women should stop doing, that doesn't mean that you have to stop doing it. I encourage dialogue. That's literally my goal with these types of conversations. So definitely leave your opinions down below. Just make sure to be respectful, because my biggest thing is I want to promote discussion that feels like it's a safe space. And, you know, we can't have that if we're spewing hate. You might hear my voice popping up, like, just to clarify some points throughout the video. But yeah, enjoy. Make sure that you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and let's get right into it. What is up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. I'm super happy that you guys clicked on this video, and I am super happy to be filming this video for you guys. Now, in today's video, as you can read from the title, this is going to be my second commentary video, and the topic of today's video is going to be a little controversial, because you know we love to start conversations here. This is a good space to have respectful conversations. So today's topic is going to be things that Black women need to stop doing. I know if you're a Black woman, you probably read that title and you're slightly triggered, and that made you click on this video because it's like, what do I need to stop doing? I'm already Black, I'm already a woman, and you tell me what I need to stop doing when there's so many other groups that I can tell to stop doing. But this video is for our best interest. When I make videos like this, it's always for the best interest of Black women. So in my last video where I talked about colorism, the comments started a really interesting conversation, especially from the male perspective, because a lot of them felt like there's so many double standards in the Black community, especially with colorism. I won't specifically, well, this video isn't specifically all about colorism, but that plays a part in it as well. But it really got me thinking about some of the things that Black women do need to change our views on in order for us to be progressive. So yeah, definitely make sure that you like, comment, subscribe, tell me what you think. I definitely want to hear respectful opinions. Everything I'm saying is coming from a place of love and respect, so I expect that energy to be returned. So yeah, I'm gonna get right into it. Okay, so topic number one, Black women, specifically even greater than Black women, like brown skin and dark skin women, really need to stop perpetuating the stereotype that light-skinned men are undesirable because they're soft and feminine. And I'm not even saying this to cape for light-skinned men, because do light-skinned men cape for brown and dark-skinned women? I don't see it that often. I'm saying this because it works in our best interest. So when you're sitting here saying that I don't mess with light skins because they're soft or because they're feminine, what you're also saying in a way is that dark skin is hard and masculine. And you, as somebody that has dark skin, that definitely works against your interest, because you're a Black woman and that stereotype is what strips your femininity from you. It's what makes the world have this idea that you always have to be so strong. And it's the reason why Black women are part of literally one of the only communities where we are expected to take on so many roles. And it's actually a contributing factor to why Black women are dying at alarming rates in hospitals. So the science behind it, or the thought behind it, is that doctors think that Black women have a higher pain tolerance than other groups because of our dark skin. So for us to sit here and be the ones who are also perpetuating the same stereotype that is making us be killed in hospitals, murdered in a way, it's really just like, it's irresponsible on our part, and it's something that we definitely need to take into consideration. Topic number two. Let me tell y'all, this one, I'm coming for y'all. I'm coming. Have I ever done this? I probably have. I definitely have, but I'm coming for us. Number two, stop criticizing Black women so heavily, like other Black women so heavily. This applies to all groups of us. Light skin, brown skin, dark skin, we're all one race, but you know what I mean. Like, specifically, stop criticizing our hair so heavily. Like, we're not allowed to have a bad hair day. My edges aren't laid, so I'm ugly today. Like, her wig is lifted, so she's a bum.
Like, it's really not that deep. Somebody want to get their hair relaxed and it's a controversy. Whether your hair is relaxed, natural, damaged, it's really nobody's business. Or whether somebody else's hair is like that. So learn how to not watch face. Learn how to mind your business. Because it's really not your place to be so judgmental on other black women. And granted, we've all done it. Like, you see somebody wig lifted and you be like, I get it. But it's just like, keep your opinion to yourself. You can think it without saying it. Because especially because us as black women, we know the struggle. We know what we grew up experiencing with our hair. So for us to be so hypercritical with each other, it's honestly ridiculous. And we need to change that. All right, so topic number three. Stop responding to men who are blatantly gaslighting black women. We are giving these men careers. Like, they're living off the back of black woman outrage. There's sometimes where it's like black men are stating something, or not even black men. Well, no, it's mainly black men. Black men are stating something, and then, you know, us as black women, we feel like we have a different opinion. But you can tell when it's coming from a genuine place or when it's coming from a hateful place to where they're just trying to get our reactions. It's 2021. If you can't tell, then just don't respond to none of it at all. But for the most part, you can tell when it's gaslighting versus when it's genuine, like they're just not on the same page. You can correct it, but don't go back and forth. Don't make these people famous. I'm not gonna say a specific name because that would basically be me giving the person more clout, because if you don't know who he is already, I'm not gonna put you onto him. But there's a specific man who's literally out here getting a bag, got a whole career off of clowning, disrespecting, and degrading black women. So it's really just like, we should not be letting them get in these positions from disrespecting us. We're doing ourselves a disservice. So really the proper thing to do that is to do when you see that is just don't pay no mind, because they don't even deserve that time. And actually that leads into topic number four. So we definitely need to stop making men famous for disrespecting us, but we also need to stop fiending, I feel like would be the best word. Like, stop fiending when a man says that his preference is black women. Like, it's one thing, like, for example, the first thing that comes to my mind is like TikTok. If a guy says like his type is black women, you're gonna see women in the comments taking it to the next level of thirsty. Like, it's one thing to be like, thank you, you know, I'm happy you appreciate us, something like that, but not like, rail me. Like, that's not OD. Like, nobody ever loves us. Like, I know what you mean, I feel you, but tone it down a little bit. You know, you're making us look bad. That's not good for our image. That makes us look like we're fiending. So honestly, you can support that person, you can show love to that person, but don't do that. Because also, that's leaving room for people who are just being performative in order to get clout. Because they know that if I say I like black women, oh, the black women are gonna come follow me, like my page. And they might not even genuinely like black women like that. But I'm also not telling y'all to call them out for it. Because, you know, don't call people out when they're saying, like, I like black women. Because then it's like, why do you find it so hard to believe that somebody likes black women? But at the same time, just, you know, tone it down. You don't gotta fiend. All right, so this next one, literally, I had to really sit here and think, like, do I really want to put this in this video? Because this is one of those hard truths. Hair is always a sensitive topic to talk about in the black community. This is not contradicting one of the other ones I've said, but oftentimes when a black girl gets in an argument with somebody of another race, the first thing that other person will say is something about weave or fake hair. And if that other person happens to be a white girl, a black girl will quickly come back with, we don't buy white hair, we buy Malaysian hair, we buy Indian hair, Peruvian hair, and period, poo, we do. And trust me, I'm not coming for nobody because I have bundles, okay? But my thing is, we have to start embracing our natural hair texture more.
So after listening to this part of the video, I actually wanted to come back and clarify the point that I was saying. So the connection that I was trying to make here is that black women, We take a lot of pride in not wearing Caucasian hair, when it would be an even bigger flex to see more Black women switching it up and wearing hair textures that are closer to our own. So essentially I'm saying, like, I have nothing against wearing wigs or weaves because I literally do those things myself. But it's a little problematic when you're saying, oh, I love being Black, I love my hair, I love everything about being Black, but then in the same breath, you never wear your natural hair, or you never even wear a wig or a weave that's anywhere close to your natural hair. So yeah, what I'm basically saying is, you know, let's try to embrace our hair type more, and like, let's be proud to wear our hair type.
We like to say we love our hair, but us wearing Malaysian, Brazilian, like, if you're wearing a wig 12 months out of the year and no point that wig is anywhere near similar to your hair texture, I'm not in your business, but that's a little bit weird, okay? And my thing is, yes, get extensions, especially because it's protective style, but if you can try to get something that's a little closer to home, that would definitely prove your point that, like, yes, I love my natural hair and I just like to switch it up. That's all I'm saying. That one, I know it's going to be a little controversial because when the topic of hair comes up, it's going to be sensitive regardless. But it's coming from a loving place, to be honest. And that's just something that we need to check. But all right, guys, that's all I have for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Like I said, let's be super respectful. Make sure to drop a comment because I definitely want to hear you guys' opinions. Like, comment, subscribe. What else? Oh, watch my last colorism video. That video is almost at 1,000 views, so I know y'all like this type of content. Thank you guys for watching, and am I forgetting anything?
Yo, it's your boy Matt Band. We do nice from where you already know the vibe. Bye.
Bye.
I'm on YouTube, Matt Band.
I'm on YouTube. His info is
like my last video.
It's gonna be in the description. Period. Bye.